Hi, my name is Steven and welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be talking to you about the things I plan to do in 2024. Anticipating 2024, I'm excited to tell you about what I plan to do next year. In retrospect, taking a look back at 2023, there's a lot of things that I didn't accomplish that I wanted to set out at the beginning of the year. I had some ambitious goals for the year, but just wasn't able to actually execute on them. Although it didn't unfold as expected, there was plenty of other things that were a pleasant surprise for me. In 2024, I'm going to focus on strengthening my bonds with my family. I plan to spend quality time with loved ones, nurturing relationships, and creating lasting memories. And work is also set to play a pivotal role next year for me. I come in with a renewed sense of dedication to my chosen career, and I want to excel at it in the next year. Balancing work and life will be my top priority for 2024 because I want to create a harmonious and sustainable balance for my family and I. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about my background, what I plan to do in 2024, and my general thoughts. And before we start, be sure to like, subscribe, comment, share with friends, hit that notification bell if you like this content. And let's go. This year marked a lot of firsts for me. It was the first time in my life where I had a heavy helping of responsibilities dealt in my way. And it forced me to be a better family member and leader to others. And this was the first year I had to confront challenges that I could not hide from at all. And knowing the path that I chose would change my life forever. And it started a different phase in my life where I don't know what the future path will be. I think that this is only the beginning of changes to my life, with the child being the first one. Family dynamics will play a huge part in 2024 for me and my family. And from a work perspective, I want to challenge myself to be a better leader and coworker to others so that I can look forward to motivating and have a successful team, knowing that my impacts are not just myself or my team, but for the whole company as well. Family and work are a heavy burden to bear, but I think I'm ready to take on the challenges in 2024. So here are some of the things that I plan to do in 2024. Number one, prioritize self-care. In the coming year, I'm committed to having a self-care routine and sticking to it, recognizing that it's a foundation of my physical and mental well-being. I will prioritize activities that promotes a healthier lifestyle for me and my family. That means regular exercise, healthy eating, and plenty of rest, so that I can optimize and sustain my health when I push through very heavy responsibility periods of my life. Additionally, I'll pay special attention to my mental and emotional well-being and incorporate mindfulness and meditation whenever possible in my year. This means I'm aiming to have a more balanced and fulfilling life mentally and emotionally. I think more than ever, next year, this will be on the forefront of my mind because this year was a difficult work and family year for me. I encountered things that I've never gone through before, and it challenged me to strike a balance between what I need and want in life. And if I don't sustain self-care, I'm gonna end up burning out. Because that's a real thing that could be coming for me in 2024 if I don't take care of myself. The key is to plan out times in my day and week for rest and relaxation. I need to prioritize self-care activities whenever possible. It's hard to stop or slow down when days get crazy, so I have to schedule it in advance. So I plan to do as much as I can to keep my mental, physical, and emotional health in check. Number two, family matters. As we approach the new year, I want to place a greater emphasis on my family life. The past year has reinforced the importance that I need to commit to family time. I wasn't the perfect parent that I should have been this year, and that was due to a lot of other factors. But this year, I want to focus on quality time and bonds with my family members, and make an effort to create stronger connections and lasting memories with them. By devoting more time to my loved ones, I want to create a more harmonious family life. And this kind of environment benefits everyone and fosters a deeper relationship with all those around us and create a sense of family along the next year's journey. My child will be entering the second year and my wife and I will have our hands full. He'll have more character and he'll definitely act out against us. But this process means we'll also have more solid memories as he matures. So I need to spend more time with him so I slowly watch him progress through life. I'll also focus on reconnecting with my spouse now that our son is a little bit older. The key is to also carve out time whenever I can for family time and keep up family traditions throughout the year so that we don't fall behind and forget about them. That means I need to try to balance work and life so that I don't let my career overwhelm my family life. Setting boundaries for me will be key in having a healthy 2024. So family matters, and I'll do what I can to focus on them next year. Number three, lead by example. Looking forward to next year, I want to hone in on my leadership skills at my job and work towards becoming a more successful and effective leader. I didn't start out as a leader this year, but I was thrust into this position and how vital my efforts are to the success of our team and our companies. So I plan to invest more time in seeking opportunities to further my leadership skills. this means being more attuned and attentive to the members of my team and providing them the guidance and support that they need to be successful. In the coming year, I want to foster a lead by example mentality, fostering open communication and being also a servant leader to them. I also want to empower my colleagues to foster more open communication with others on my team so that they can facilitate their own growth without me being there all the time. By doing this, I think I can be the guide for our team to be successful next year. I've led teams before, but this is by far the largest team I have ever led. And although I've made some errors this year, I aim to correct those and be a better leader for next year. Being a leader is not just about doing everything yourself or being the best among everyone else, but it's about allowing others to shine in their role so they make the whole team better as a result. The goal for me is to not only be a better leader, but manage the stress and pressures of the job as well, and being able to stay cool, calm, and collected in certain times of crises. I've not been historically good under pressure, but next year will be a perfect ground for me to test that. And so in 2024, I'm gonna focus on being and aspiring to the leader I know I can be. Number four, planning the future. In the upcoming year, I'm committed to having a solid foundation for me in the next 5 to 10 years. That means I want some future life goals set for me in the next 5 to 10 years for the next phase of my life. I recognize the significance of long-term planning, and I want to get into the mindset of figuring out what that future looks like for me. And I aim to set clear, achievable goals in a reasonable time frame. And those objectives can be across various aspects of my life: work, family, and personal growth and development. I'll strategically plan and map out the steps it'll take to make those dreams a reality. Additional financial planning for the next 5 to 10 years will be crucial for me and my family as well. This will be a comprehensive approach for the next phase of my life and give me a sense of purpose for not only the next year, but beyond. Because at the end of the day, I want to have more goals in the future so that I have something to strive for. This new phase of life isn't easy, and it might take the entire year of planning and strategizing to figure out what I want to actually do. Specifically, what in my life that I want to make a priority and I want to attain near term. Because I do know that with family life being the top priority, other things will have to fall by the wayside. As much as I have personal goals that I want to achieve, it has to take a back seat to everything else. I personally want to get back into cooking and piano when I can. The key is really to figure out what I'm passionate for in the next year and what kind of goals that drives me towards, and things that I want to try out now that I'm older in life. It won't be easy, but that's why I'm giving myself the entire year to try to figure out. So next year, I'm going to definitely plan for working towards the next phase of my life and whatever that future might hold for me. So here are some general thoughts about the things that I want to do next year. Knowing what I know about these kinds of videos that I've made in the past, one thing is for certain: there's always a huge helping of uncertainty. In the past, I had a lot of grand goals that I just wasn't able to hit. Life always has a way of throwing you challenges that you have to just stop your life and figure out. You'll have to rally around that challenge, overcome it, and then move on to the next thing. The main point is that uncertainty is all around us, and life is never certain. You'll just have to ride along with it and be as flexible and adaptable as possible. But at the very least, we have to do our part and try to plan out what we want to do in the future so that we're not caught blindsided. Having a path in life is always helpful so that we can tell when we're off course. It may not be a perfect plan, but we can at least work towards something. And so that, for me, is what I try to work on year to year, providing myself a path so that one day I can take a look back and see all that I've accomplished year by year. So I hope you enjoyed the things that I plan to do in 2024. I recognize the importance of adapting to changing conditions along the way due to multiple challenges, and we have to be flexible and adapting to changing expectations along the way. And next year, there will still be a lot of changes, but I'm narrowing down and focusing on what really matters in my life and being open to various new opportunities that might come my way, along with a persistent focus on what I actually want to do, so that not only do I focus on family and work, but a balance in between that. By focusing on this, I can make the most out of my 2024, and any opportunities that come my way will just be the cherry on top. So thank you for watching. Please leave me a comment down below on what are some of the things that you are most looking forward to in 2024. And I'll see you next time.